Hello friends, and a happy welcome to those watching for the first time. My name is Christian Bear. My creator, Don, operates the tinyurl.com/kidsvideos website. I know, I am just a teddy bear. But I have a great story to share today. The story for today is called The Farmer Sows His Seeds. Once, there was a farmer who went out to plant seeds in his field. This was a long time before farmers had tractors and other machines. So the farmer had to plant the seeds by hand. The farmer did this by making a cloth bag to hold his seeds. And the seed bag had a long strap so the farmer could hang it from his shoulder. Then the farmer would walk back and forth across the field, taking his hands full of seed from his bag and scattering the seed on the ground. This is called sowing seed. Let us pretend the field was next to a road in the country. Or the field could be a vacant lot in the city with a street next to it. Parts of the field were bumpy and stony, and there were patches of weeds and sticker bushes. In order to get the best crop, the farmer wanted to cover the field with as many seeds as possible. So, he started at the edge of the field and went right across, moving up and moving down the field, sowing his seeds everywhere on the field. Sometimes, a puff of wind would blow the seeds onto the road, or some of the seeds would miss the field when the farmer scattered them near the edge. Birds always notice when a farmer sows seeds in his field. They like to wait until the farmer moves away from the seeds, so they can eat them. The seeds that fall on the pavement of the road are easiest for the birds to find, so they quickly gobble them up and the seeds do not even get a chance to sprout. The seeds that fall on the bumpy and stony parts of the field got a chance to sprout, but when the sun came up, the baby plants could not get any water from the hard ground. If baby plants cannot get any water, the heat of the sun dries them out and they get all crispy and die. Some of the seeds fell in the weedy parts of the field. These seeds sprouted and grew at first, but later the weeds grew up around them and used up all the water and sunlight. Weeds always seem to grow faster than the crops that the farmer wants. So these young plants also died before they could make any food. Lastly, there are the seeds that fell in the middle of the field where the ground was soft and moist. These seeds grew up big and strong and made good food that the farmer took home to feed everybody. When Jesus told this story, J.H.E. was pretending to be the farmer. Jesus was also pretending that the seeds were the good things that he wanted the people to know. These good things are called the gospel. The seeds that fell on the pavement were like the people who were sitting around where Jesus was teaching, but were not paying attention. The good things that Jesus was telling them went in one side of their head and out the other. And the birds took them away, so they could not grow and do any good. The seeds that fell on the hard stony ground were like the people who heard Jesus and thought that the things Jesus was teaching them sounded good, but they went right out and started playing games and goofing off with their friends. When they were finished playing, they had forgotten all about what Jesus had taught them, so once again, the good words did not do them any good. Remember the third group of seeds. The ones which fell in the weedy patches. They are like the people who heard the words of Jesus and thought it sounded good, like the second group of people. They took the word of Jesus and tried to act like he told them to, and they were doing pretty well for a while. But they also wanted to play and goof off with their friends, and their friends did not want to do what Jesus said to do. So they gradually forgot the words of Jesus and just acted like their friends. So in a little while they were not doing what Jesus said. But the fourth group listened to Jesus, then went home and told their friends and their family the good news. They still played with their friends and all, but they remembered what Jesus had taught them and helped their friends to understand Jesus, too. They lived their whole lives helping their friends to understand Jesus, and so they did a lot of good for all their friends and everybody else. I want to thank you for listening and watching today's video story. And always give God the glory. And always give God the honor. And always give God the praise. For only He is worthy of praise. And please, consider accepting Jesus as your Savior today. You need to know that Jesus is the only way into the heavenly kingdom. Dawn and me would love to play with you in heaven one day. Please, join me again. And please, visit thetinyurl.com/kidsvideos website for more kids videos. Bye. Thank you.